We're over at Jamie Moore's gym in Salford. I'm joined by one of Salford's own, Mark Leach, English bantamweight champion. It's good to see you, Mark. Nice work there on the pads with Nigel. And I don't know the other guy.
Hassan, first
time I've met him today. Working tactics for this fight you've got coming up in a couple of weeks, 17th of October, against Cash Ashback. Interesting fight, because I've seen you in here sparring with Cash. I've seen you training with him side by side, and your trainer, Nigel, his dad used to train.
Yeah, he's the same, it's a very close dynamic, this one, isn't it? Yeah, we've both got similar styles. It's going to be a chess match, yes, I know it is. It's going to be hard, it's going to be tough. I'm moving up a weight, so everything's in his favour. But I've trained hard for this fight, you know, in there, I'm feeling sharp, getting the rounds in with some good awkward fighters just like me and Kez. So yeah, I can't wait for this fight now. Time for me to shine on the Sky show, so I'm grabbing it with both hands.
It's a big show. It's like an opportunity you've been
waiting for years, yeah. He's not getting the opportunity, like I say, it's not really a massive ticket sale, so this goal has come at the right time for me, kind of thing, so can't wait now.
That's a problem with a lot of boxers, you know, the fighting, the training, you find natural, but then you've got to promote yourself, sell tickets, run around with tickets.
Yeah, that's the hardest thing. Yeah, I mean, you can train, you can be the best at anything, but if you can't sell the tickets, you can't get a big show, so it's just a bit of a nightmare for me, because like I say, I can't really sell the tickets, but I've got the ability to get up there. So hopefully this fight on the 17th is just opens the doors for me, kind of thing, and people start getting behind me, especially from Salford, you know, and help me get them world titles and bring them back to Salford where they belong.
When this fight was put to you, was it as strange to you at the time?
I thought they got mixed up at first because they gave me two names, but then they said, yeah, it's Cassius. Keza said, yeah, we'll have it. So I just thought, I'll fight anyone, anywhere, any place. So I'm not really bothered who it is. It's business at the end of the day. But yeah, I've got nothing against him. We trained here with good mate. So like a chess match. So looking forward to it.
Have you ever fought anyone you know so well and know their LA box so well as well?
No, it's the first time, this one, yeah.
It's this personal?
Yeah. It's not personal. It's just business, isn't it, really? It's like, I've got to feed the kids, he's got to feed his family, so it's part of the business. You've got to fight your friends, and after the ring, I'm sure we'll fucking shake hands and then have a beer or whatever, let's go for some food, so yeah.
But you're confident you can win. What gives you that confidence?
You got to believe in yourself, basically. If you don't believe in yourself, there's no point being in the sport, and I believe I'm the best at my weight of what I can do, so I know I can be world champion. Just getting the opportunity and the backing behind me to get up there, which is the hardest part, but it's getting there slowly but surely, hence this opportunity now.
I was just saying to Jamie as well, there's a lot of boxers at the moment not getting the opportunities, so it's good that you have.
Yeah, definitely. Like I say, I'm going to grab it with both hands as well. I'm not going to let this slide. It's a really big platform to be on, and hopefully it progresses to more opportunities on the day or in the Sky.
You know, you won the English bantamweight title a couple of fights ago. I'm sure the plan was to stay at bantamweight and defend the title or move on to British level, but... Yeah. Did you ever have the plans to move up in weight anyway, or was it this fight that...
The plans was to fight for the British as soon as possible at my weight, because I've always wanted that. You know, James had that belt, I wanted that belt, follow his footsteps, bring it back to Salford, you know, home from home, and then we'll go for the world champion from there. But like I said, I'll fight anyone. I'll move up 2 weights if that's where the fights are. If they're the televised fights, 2 weights up, I'll move 2 weights up. I'll move a weight up like I have done now. So the opponents aren't really too forced on me. It's just getting the opportunity. I've said to Jamie and Nigel, all I need to do is offer me the fight, and I'll accept it. I'm sure they'll accept it. So it's just, like I say, getting the opportunity to fight them people, which is the hardest part.
What is it that you think will see you prevail in this fight? What is it that you've got just slightly more there than Cash that'll see?
I just think I've got the better reflexes, you know. I reckon, like, now this training camp is the sharpest I've ever felt, you know. So I reckon I'll be sharper and a lot quicker, you know, because I'm going up a weight as well, so I'll have the speed on my side. I'll have the power on his side, I'll have the speed on my side, so I reckon the speed will prevail. I can take a punch anyway, so... And like I said, we sparred quite a few times. We both know each other's style, ins and out, basically, but it's whoever is training the hardest on the night, you know, which game plan works out. And I believe mine, Jamie's, Nigel's game plan is on point.
It excites you as well to be on such a big bill. It's almost like you've been under the radar a lot, Mark. You know, and you are from Salford, and you're trained by a Salford legend there in Jamie Moore as well, and it's just not quite clicked there, but this is your moment now to get all Salford behind you now, isn't it? And yeah, to see that we have got another lad here who is coming through and he's deserving of being another local hero.
Yeah, like I say, he's just trying to get the backing through the Salford family. If they come when it was Steve as well, even if they support against them, and they can sell quite a few tickets, and then Steve then will make it, it'll be a lot easier for Steve to make the bigger fights as well and to get on the bigger shows. But because I don't sell that many at the minute, it's a bit of a hard for him. So I reckon he's probably losing money putting me on shows, but I've sent me out to Steve and I thank for everything for all he's done. But this is a really big opportunity for me and I don't want to let it slide.
What about boxing behind closed doors as well? This will be the first time you've done that.
It won't really bother me. We train and we spar behind closed doors, so it's just going to be nothing, like no different from that, you know. Obviously, it'd be good to have the fans there, you know, they hear him cheering you on. But on the other hand, it won't make a difference to me anyway. You know, I'll be focused in that ring. When you're in that ring, you don't really hear. You only hear the corners anyway, and you hear the odd one or two big shouts or a bit like the chanting and stuff like that. But you can't hear. You don't really listen to him. Without being disrespectful, you listen to your coaches and they're there to spur you on when you need to dig deep. So it'd just be another day in the office for me.
I first met you, Mike, over at Oliver's gym, the other side of Salford.
Yeah.
You're over here with Jamie now. Jamie was a student of Oliver as well. Yeah. I knew Oliver, I've known him for years as well, and he was a great person.
Yeah.
And anyone in boxing knows what a great trainer he was as well, sorely missed in the game. It was hard, sort of, you know, for that to happen, but it kind of transitioned over during when
boxers
came over.
That's what it did, yeah. Me, Martin, Rocky, Oliver said, come here, and Jamie Moore, they spoke to each other, Jamie and Oliver, to can we come over here and train while it gets better? But then it turned for the worst, and we've been here. But it's like home from home, so everything Oliver knew, he talked to Jamie, and everything Jamie taught, learned off him, we're now learning off Jamie, plus we've also got experience through Oliver ourselves and training from ourselves over the years. So it's, like I said, it's home from home, so I was very happy with that, yeah.
For someone who was close with Oliver and trained with him for many years, came through with Oliver as well.
Yeah.
What type of guy was he?
He used to come around, like when he used to live, when I was a kid in school, he used to come around at my dad's, you know, have the brandy and Diet Coke on the side just to watch boxing. So he used to come around and just have a chat then. You know, put the boxing on, he'll have a set brandy. We used to buy like Diet Coke, that's all he'd have with it. And stuff like that, he'd come around, he'd have a little chip, like a chin wag with me and my dad and stuff, and he'd go to the gym, have a laugh. Yeah, he's really like down to earth, yeah.
And as a coach?
Perfect. You know, he was very cool, calm and collected. You know, he never really shouted, and if he did, or if he swore, you knew he did something wrong, so you knew that was when you need to get up off your backside and start training a bit harder again, yeah.
Rest in peace, Oliver.
Yeah, absolutely. Definitely.
All the very best, mate. I wish you best in camp. God bless you in this fight, both of you. And yep. I'm sure it's going to be a cracker.
Will do. Cheers. Cheers. Definitely. Thank you.